This week's responding to your comments is all about farting or flatulence. We got a comment from Flat Turbo One. Commented, Abraham, please make a video on how to stop farting as sometimes the gas causes so much pain in my stomach. Well, your wish is my command. What are we waiting for? Let's go. So let's begin with tip number one. Sip on some warm water. This can provide instant relief if you're really having a problem with flatulence right now. Just by sipping on some warm water, it's gonna help with digestion, it's gonna help reduce inflammation, it's gonna help reduce the tension, and it's gonna help with those symptoms. So give it a go right after the end of this video. And diving straight onto tip number two, smaller meals and gas-producing foods. So, if you're someone who has heavy meals throughout the day, you need to try and stop this. You need to have smaller meals, little and often. If you're having big meals, it's gonna cause a big amount of gas, which is gonna cause all the farting and flatulence that we don't want. Secondly, gas-producing foods. Certain foods produce more gas. For example, beans, broccoli, onions. You need to try and stay away from these or have them in moderation. Instead, we're gonna opt for grains, we're gonna opt for leaner proteins, we're gonna opt for vegetables. They're all fine to have, but the most important thing is you need to have a healthy, balanced meal.
Really important.
So next up, let me tell you about our sponsor, BRIOSCHI. This fast-acting, medicine-free digestive aid has been part of Italian homes for over 100 years, and it's now reached the US and Canada. To learn more about BRIOSCHI today, I'm gonna leave a link to their Amazon page in the description below. And moving straight on to tip number three, let's talk about gut biome. Gut biome is a fancy word for the bacteria in your gut. Your gut is like a city. It's full of different bacteria, and we want the good stuff because the good stuff is gonna help us with that flatulence, okay? So you need to be having foods that are rich in good bacteria. For example, kimchi is really good, kombucha is really good, certain yogurts are really good. Basically fermented stuff, they're all really good, generally speaking. But it's also crucial to be mindful of what's not good for your gut biome. So for example, you shouldn't be having lots of foods that are processed or sugary foods. All of these can disrupt that gut flora and contribute to the bloating symptoms that we're experiencing. And diving straight into tip number four, get moving. Kind of like me in this video, you need to do a bit of exercise. You need to do a bit of walking. Any movement like that is gonna aid digestion and it's gonna help get that gas moving. Why is that good? Because if we don't do it, that gas is gonna build up and continue to grow like a balloon. And then that's what leads to the flatulence and the pain in the stomach from all the gas. So you need to get moving. Just a little bit of walking is gonna get that gas moving so it keeps the balloon nice and small. That is exactly what we want, and you're gonna see massive improvements if you do that. Now, with all gut and stomach issues, there are times where you should speak to a healthcare professional, because sometimes these symptoms can be a sign of something else that's going on that needs to get checked out urgently. So please do read the description. I'm gonna leave loads more information in there on when you should seek medical advice. I really hope my tips help. As always, sending awesome vibes, and I'll see you next week.